today I'm going to review Wake in Fright from 1971. This was a really interesting movie that I saw as part of my discussion group at the Anne Arundel County Library. It is a kind of a chilling look at the Australian society in the outback. How can I describe this? Okay, this man is, the main character is a school teacher who is, if you saw the show Northern Exposure and know about the concept of a person working off a debt paid in order to get, working somewhere unpleasant in order to pay off an education. That's what's going on here. He's basically an indentured servant at that point to the state because they paid for his education, his ability to get a degree. And so he's working in this tiny little place in the middle of nowhere. I mean, you don't even see any houses around. The opening shot just really made me think of Bad Day at Black Rock. There's something about the outback that reminds me so much of the American West, and there's probably a lot of parallels we could draw there. I mean, between the indigenous people situation and the everything, really, there are probably a number of interesting parallels. But having said that, we are in the outback, and it's Australia, and this whole movie is very, very Australian. And Andrew Netty was at our discussion and talked about that, about how essentially this is about, there's so much of this movie there's a lot to this movie, but I mean, I just want to emphasize that he had brought up that Australian, how did he put it, toxic masculinity was just infused throughout this movie, and yes, definitely, I have to agree with him there, boy. And there's this one woman character, I mean, who just kind of personifies the whole horrible situation for a person in that kind of setting. Now, the thing that gets to me is the protagonist. I mean, I knew what he was going to do, and it's like, boy, you're dumb. Wow, I mean, here he is in this strange situation, obviously not comfortable, and he's trying so hard to fit in. That is what really got me, I mean, watching this movie, how much this guy, I mean, after failing, after what you know is going to be a failed attempt to get out of his obligations, this guy tries so hard to fit in, instead of trying hard to leave town, like he keeps saying he wants to do. Anyway, that's what one of the things that really struck me. Well, that and the similarity to the beginning to Bad Day at Black Rock, because in a sense, this was like a bad weekend at Black Rock, only on steroids. serious steroids. So, this is not an easy film to watch, period, for many reasons. One of them being this kangaroo kill, which was actually the footage is gruesome and it is real. And humane societies were consulted before this was made part of the movie. That's another one of the interesting things about this movie. But then finally, my final point is, somebody pointed out during the discussion that this is a Christmas movie, which it is. Yeah, it actually starts at Christmas. So, which brought up another question for me. Where the hell did all those kids go? I mean, you see them at the beginning of the movie, you know, they're just sitting there, and then finally they're dismissed, and they run out the door, and I'm like, okay, where did they go? Where do these kids live? Do they walk 10 miles to school? Does anybody pick them up? How does that work? I don't know. I mean, this is the outback. I mean, I don't know. I should have asked Andrew Netty that question. Perhaps he will be kind enough to leave a comment about where the hell all these kids went after they left the schoolhouse And it's like a one-room schoolhouse, right? You know, you can picture this, right? It's straight out of Little House on the Prairie. Yeah, it's a Hallmark movie. I'm kidding, of course. Oh boy, there is actually more I wanted to say that I left out of the first take. It reminds me so much of Bad Day at Black Rock, not only because the situation is so bleak for this protagonist who's trying to get away to Sydney. I forgot to mention, he's trying to get to the city of Sydney. There, you know, the railroad tracks run through this, they run right by the schoolhouse where he works, and across the street is his landlord. And he basically lives, I believe, at the schoolhouse there. So it's like there's nothing around other than these two buildings. And the opening shot is just so beautifully done to show you that. I mean, it's a 360 circle, you know, shot where you see nothing but these two buildings. Oh, the other thing I wanted to add was the reason I bring up the woman is, one thing I wanted to say was, it's kind of, being a woman in this place would be like being the only woman at a frat party with a bunch of 19-year-olds, drunk 19-year-olds, or maybe drunk 14-year-olds, and you're in the middle of nowhere. Yeah, picture that. And, wow, kind of left me with a feeling of, do I ever really want to go to the Outback? I don't know. Okay, that was it then. Thanks.